Hi friends, it's Gwen, and I'm here a little bit early to film my July wrap-up. The reason being, and I haven't really completed hopefully my last book of the month, but the reason why I'm filming it early, and I will do a bit of an announcement at the end, is because I'm gonna be MIA for the month of August. Now hold on, that doesn't mean I'm gonna be MIA from BookTube. I'm gonna do my best to pre-film some tags and some top five Wednesdays and maybe some Tuesday talks. So I shouldn't be completely gone as far as videos for you to view, but I will be gone from the comments and watching your videos and commenting. I'll be MIA on Twitter a lot and Instagram and Snapchat and all of those things. So I will get into that more at the end, but let's go ahead and jump into the books that I read in July. The first book that I read in July was Drama by Rena Taugemeier. It is the middle grade graphic novel that I have talked quite a bit about already on my channel in a couple of tags. This graphic novel was a complete surprise. I rated it 5 out of 5 stars. I borrowed it from my library via the Overdrive app, and I read it very quickly. It was about a girl who works backstage in the new production at her middle school, and it was just completely like theater kid graphic novel, but it also had some LGBTQ elements in it, which were surprising, unexpected, shocking, and I really enjoyed it. So if you enjoy reading middle grade or graphic novels in general, you should pick this up. It's super cute and it's a very fast read. Again, I rated it 5 stars. The next book that I read is Anna and the French Kiss by Stephanie Perkins, and I have had this on my shelf for over a year and I finally picked it up. I was hoping to read all three of the Stephanie Perkins companion novels this summer, but this is the only one I've gotten to so far. I loved it. I rated it 5 stars. It's about Anna, who goes away to school in France, and she kind of meets people, makes new friends, falls in love, and it's really cute. I highly recommend it if you are a contemporary lover like I am. The next book that I read is The Body Farm by Patricia Cornwell, and I do have a review, or I will have a full review of this book on my channel. This is the book that I chose to reread as part of my TBR jar challenge to reread a favorite book, and I'm not a huge rereader, but I did reread this one and I rated it 4 stars. Next, I read Mechanica by Betsy Cornwell. I was sent this ARC for review and I rated it 3.5 to 4 stars. I will have a full review of this on my channel on August 1st to celebrate the release. But basically, it is a Cinderella retelling about a girl who discovers that her mother, discovers her mother's workshop and all of the steampunk elements and magic and machines, and it's super fun. The next one that I read is You by Carolyn Kepnes, and I rated this 4 out of 5 stars. It was engrossing. It was scary and thrilling, and Joe, what can I say? I saw Lainey talk about this like a year ago, and she enjoyed it, and I enjoyed it just as much as she did. I think she rated it 4 stars, and I'm rating it 4 stars. The reason why I'm rating it 4 stars instead of 5 stars is because the author chose to use the word deaf as an idiom that just wasn't appropriate in my book, and I want to go ahead and say I am an American Sign Language interpreting student, so I deal a lot with the deaf community. A lot of my instructors are deaf, and just kind of knowing that background, I'm really a little bit more sensitive to those things. Page 253. Sure, I said, I don't care anymore. I'm so dead that I'm deaf. I don't know. I think you could have chosen something else. Page number 322. I hit pause again because I'm going deaf from anger. I know what the author is trying to say, but it could have been said in a different way where I would have appreciated it a little bit more. Page number 369. She says sometimes that she's so crazy about me that she goes deaf when I talk. Really? Again, I think another word choice would have been better fitted there. But Joe is completely creepy. You end up kind of like feeling like sad for him and like wanting things to work out. But then as soon as you start feeling that way, you're reminded that he's a total creeper. So I absolutely love this book. I'm excited for book number two. And yeah, I highly recommend this book if you're into the thriller type of books. Next book that I read is Every Day by David Levithan. I borrowed this from the library and I rated it 4 stars. This is the story of A who travels every day into a new body, whether it be a boy or a girl, gay or straight, athletic or nerdy, homeschooled or not. There were just so many characters in this book that I loved, from the 300-pound person to the person that has a mental illness, to someone that is biologically female but gendered male, to just, I just loved all of the characters in here so much. I ended up rating this 4 stars instead of 5 stars because the main love interest in this book wasn't taking well to some of the characters that A was becoming, and her reaction to them was really bothering me, and I didn't know how to handle it. Like, at times I was just like, wow, I can't believe she's being like that. And I guess, like, if I thought about it longer, like, I can understand. But the writing was beautiful, the ending was poetic, and I highly recommend you pick this up if you haven't already. I know book two is either out or coming out very soon, or it's been out a long time. I know there's another book, so that's all I really know. This one did have 5 additional days from A's, you know, life in it, and I thought that was very interesting, so loved it. Finally, there are 2 books that I am currently reading. The first one being The Shore by Sarah Taylor. When I requested this book, I did not know that it was literary fiction. And me and literary fiction, we're kind of a little bit like oil and water. We don't really mix that well, but it's not like I'm totally giving up on it. This book, the stories take place on the shore, which is like basically like in Virginia, close to where I live, and a lot of the towns that are mentioned in here, I'm like, oh, I know where that is. Oh, I've been there. That's like 20 minutes away from me. So I thought that was really cool. But Sarah Taylor is kind of like one of the new hyped literary fiction authors out there, and everybody is loving this. I've only read the first 2 stories. It's basically a set of short stories that kind of intertwine and stuff like that. And I've only read the first 2 stories so far. The first story I really liked. I'd probably rate like a 4 or a 5 stars. And the second story, I really couldn't connect with it, and I don't know why I wasn't connecting with it, but it was okay. I would do like 2 or 3 stars for that one, but I'm not sure how the stories connect yet or anything like that, but I'm looking forward to finishing the rest. I'm gonna take Colleen's advice and not rush through it. Since they are short stories, I'm gonna take my time with it and like hopefully enjoy it a little bit better than if I just like rushed through it and forced myself. And the last book that I'm reading is another book that I picked up from the library. You probably can't see it that well because it's like completely white cover. But this is Speechless by, I always forget her first name, I'm so sorry, Hannah Harrington. This is Speechless by Hannah Harrington. Yes, it's very white, so I'm going to go ahead and like bring it down. I'm only on page 138, so a little bit less than halfway through it. So far, I am really enjoying it. But it is about a girl who has a very hard time keeping a secret. And I knew it was about like a secret that she couldn't keep, and she kind of spilled the beans and then people ostracized her for it. And in the beginning, I thought it was going to be one secret, and I was like, really? Like, that's not really that big of a secret. But then another secret comes and you're like, oh my gosh. And then she spills that secret and it's just like, oh my gosh, wow. And she really is being ostracized. I am enjoying it so far. I wanted to actually finish this up so I could have my full thoughts on it, but I'm just going to have to post them later on for you guys because I need to do this little video for you guys now. So now I'm going to go ahead and explain why So I want to go ahead and explain to you guys what's going on this month. Right now, as I am filming this today, it is July 27th, which means I am exactly 12 days away from getting married. I'm so excited, but that means I've been really stressed out and like scrambling and getting everything done. I had my bridal shower this weekend, and I have a lot of errands to do this week, and my family's coming in next week, and our best man's coming in next week, and I just have a lot of things to get done. So what I wanted to do is let you guys know that I'm gonna do my absolute best to continue posting as regular. I am pre-filming a couple of tags and talks and, you know, top five Wednesdays and Tuesday talks, hopefully, if they post the topic soon. I don't want to be like completely gone out of BookTube, but I want to let you guys know that if I'm not replying to your comments on my videos or I'm not watching your videos, that's probably why. I'm not going to completely be gone, like out of the state or anything. I'm getting married on August 8th. So that week, like my family's going to be here. I'm going to be spending time with them. I'm getting married. Then of course we're spending the night at the oceanfront. And then I have a week off where my fiance will still be working and I will be here packing up for our official honeymoon. We are going out of the country for our honeymoon, so I'm not going to be able to upload or be anywhere near social media. So if, like, worst case scenario, if you don't see me for like about a month, that is why, but I promise you that I will be back. My BookTube anniversary is coming up on August 7th, which is just one day like shy of when I'm getting married. So my two anniversaries are back to back, which is exciting. But I do have like a little fun video coming for you guys, actually on either the 7th or the 8th of August. Like I said, I do have a couple things like pre-filmed already. I'm hoping to pre-film a little bit more, but I'm gonna be back towards the end of August because school is starting. So as soon as I get back from my honeymoon, the very next day school starts. And of course the first 2 weeks are kind of, you know, getting into the groove of the new schedule and so forth. So I'm not sure how much I'm gonna be able to respond and leave comments and watch videos for August, but I promise that I will be back in full force in September. I'm gonna do what I can, but there are no promises whatsoever. I hope you understand that you stick with me because I look forward to seeing you all again very soon. But that's it for today. I hope you've enjoyed the books that I've talked to you about that I've read this month. I really had like a really good reading month. They were all like 4 or 5 star books, so that's always like really exciting. And yeah, I'm so excited because I'm in such a happy place in my life right now. Little bit of anxiety, I'm not gonna lie, but other than that, I'm doing pretty good. But yeah, everybody have a great August, and I will see you in my pre-recorded videos, and then I'll see you again in September. Bye!